Hi, my name is Jim Passwaters. I am Delmarva Poultry Industries Vegetative Environmental Buffers Coordinator. During my 12-year tenure with DPI, one of my goals is to always find new species to add to the buffer program. I call these edible landscapes because they produce berries that are edible. The first species that I want to show you is called black chokeberry. It's an aronia species. It's a native to Delaware. Spring, full of white flowers. The white flowers turn into these berries that are edible. This is an extremely nice plant. This hedgerow has been here for 5 years. You can see it's all of uniform size, virtually maintenance free. No trimming, no insect pests. We did have a little bit of deer browse when they first started, but once they got up over knee high, seemed like the deer went away. These are the aronia berries, and you can see they're similar in shape and size to a blueberry. I like the taste. A lot of people don't like the taste, but as I said, very healthful for you. If you can make them into a smoothie, into scones, or anything like that, put them in your cereal, it's great. Very easy to establish, easily accessible. There's plenty of them on the market. And as again, like I said, virtually maintenance free, 8 to 10 feet tall, spread about 6 to 8 feet wide, stick them in the ground. Never have to worry about them ever again. The second plant I want to introduce you to is the blackberry. This variety happens to be Apache. And as you can see, the hedge on this one gets about 8 to 10 feet tall. We have it trellised. Doesn't necessarily have to be trellised. We do it just because it's easier for us to pick the berries. This plant, again, is about 4 to 5 years old. This is the maximum height that it will get. And we get literally hundreds of pounds of blackberries off of this hedge. Makes a nice hedge, does keep its leaves longer than the aronia berries. This one will keep leaves pretty much until like November to the December time frame. We have some people that come in and collect the leaves because they make tea out of it. Again, these are thornless, no thorns on them. Only issue we've had with these is that the Japanese beetles do get on them, and we spray with a organic spray called pyrethrum, but we let the Japanese beetles eat a few of them themselves. They're spaced at about 6 feet apart, readily accessible. Again, it makes a very nice edible hedge. So you can see it's fully thick, so people can't see through it. Do not suggest planting either of these two fruits in front of the tunnel fans, because we don't want folks eating berries that may have some collected dust and things on them of that. 20 feet before the tunnel fans is fine. It only takes about 6 to 8 feet to make a nice hedgerow that will be beneficial to you, to wildlife, and to the environment as well.